Okay, in this problem we have a spacecraft traveling towards Earth at a constant velocity, and it launches a probe ahead of itself, also at constant velocity, which will obviously be faster than the probe coming toward the spacecraft coming towards us. Earth sees the spacecraft approach at half c and the probe at 0.7 c. What is the speed of the probe relative to the spacecraft? As I mentioned before, I'm not sure if I did, but once you get to grips with the problems that we've had now, obviously the next type of problems are just going to ask you to mess around with the equations a bit. That's the way physics textbooks work. Okay, we've just got to decide which is which. We go back to our triangle. B is, for obvious reasons, going to be the Earth. I think no one would disagree with that. C was going to be our little truck, and the ball thrown from the truck was going to be the probe A. So what were we given? We were given Earth sees the spacecraft approach it. So that's going to be this CB, so we have VCB, which is 0.5C. We have the probe approach us, that's the ball being thrown, that's AB. VAB is going to equal 0.7C. So we want to know AC. We want to know the speed of the probe relative to the spacecraft. So we want VAC. Now, VAC is in two places on the right-hand side of our equation, so we have to do simple algebra. Let's do that quickly. I can multiply both sides by this denominator. If I multiply it out, we're going to get VAB, plus we're going to get VAB again. We're going to have VAC, we're going to have a VCB, we're going to divide that all by C squared, and that's going to equal VAC plus a VCB. We want VAC is what we want. We can bring this VAC to this side, so we're going to hand it in. We can take it out as a, let's do the whole thing. VAC, we're going to bring to this side. Let's do it properly. We're going to have this VAB, a containing VAC that we required, the VCB divided by C squared. We bring the VAC to this side, and that leaves us with the VCB minus VAB. We're going to take out VAC as a common factor, VAC as a common factor, and we're going to multiply what is left behind. We divide both sides by that, so that will leave us a VCB on this side minus a VAB. And that's going to be divided by, I took an AC out of this, so I'm left with VAB, VCB over C squared minus 1. And if you plug all of those in, you'll get an answer for VCB, or VAC, which we got on our own. I think, where is the problem on my side? I've forgotten where on the board I had done that. And there. That gives me a 0.3C. But that is, as far as this spacecraft is concerned, it is launching that probe at 0.3C. We on Earth, though, see that probe coming at 0.7C. This is a good problem. Suppose that the speed of light is 65 meters per second and not the 300,000 kilometers per second. Now we know your speed relative to the ground is 25 meters per second, and there's a truck that has a speed relative to the ground of 35 meters per second, but you are approaching each other. What is the speed of the truck, not its velocity, so talking absolute value, what is the speed of the truck relative to you? So who is going to be who in our famous triangle? So your speed relative to the ground, the truck's speed relative to the ground, so there better be some ground that's standing still, and we always try to make that B, don't we? So this is the ground. Let's make this the ground. The truck has a relative velocity to B and the car and you. So let's make this U. Let's make U, and this, let's make this the truck. Okay, so once we have that, we can set up what we know. So we know your speed towards the ground, but you and the truck are in opposite directions, so one of them you better choose as positive and one we better choose as negative. Even though we want speed, this is relative to each other, and that is an opposite direction. So let's make your speed negative. Let's make your speed a negative speed. So we have V, that is U to the ground, AB, and that is going to be a negative 25 meters per second. we have the truck relative to the ground, okay, coming in that, going in the opposite direction. So we have VCB, and that equals negative, well, we chose that as negative, so we'll have to choose this as positive, 35 meters per second. And what we want to know is the truck relative to U, so that's going to be VAC. Again, as in the previous problem, we want VAC. We've already done an equation for VAC, where we got VAC on its own, and that was, I'm just going to look at it there, and it's going to be VCB minus VAB divided by VAB VCB over C squared minus 1. And that gives me, check on your own calculator, that's going to give me a VAC. Where is my problem? Remember, C now being 65, C being 65 meters per second, that gives me negative 50 meters per second, which for absolute value is going to be 50 meters per second. Now we have the spaceship Enterprise, which moves away from Earth at 0.65C. We have Enterprise 2, who's already ahead of Enterprise 1, and it moves with a speed relative to Enterprise 1 of 0.31C. We want to know the velocity or the speed of Enterprise 2 relative to the Earth. We say that they're all both moving in the same direction along the same line. So here, certainly, we don't have to worry about the signs. So who's A, who's C, and who's B? Well, the person, the one standing still, which we always try to make B in our analogy with a car, and the person on the car throwing a ball. So this is going to be Earth, I would suggest. Now, they're certainly moving in that direction and away from us for this, or they can be moving in that direction, but we always try to make this positive. But so we can just move B along this way, just skew this triangle so that it still makes sense, in as much as C moves away from B, and then A is ahead of that and moves further away. So certainly that is going to be the ball, which is Enterprise 2, which moves relative to Enterprise 1. So we'll make that Enterprise 1. I don't think there's any difficulty there again. So what do we have? We have Enterprise 1 moves away from Earth. Enterprise 1 moving away from Earth, so certainly we have VCB, that is 0.65C. Now we have Enterprise 2 relative to Enterprise 1, so it is the ball being thrown from the truck. So we have AC, we have VAC, equals 0.31C. And what do we want? We want Enterprise 2 relative to the Earth, we want VAB, we want VAB. We have an equation for VAB. If you plug those in, I get VAB of 0.8C. There's a much more interesting problem. We're building two identical spacecraft in the distant future, and as we measure them on Earth, they're each 1.5 kilometers in length. Now, in this direction of the length, both of them are launched in the exact same direction. First one travels at 0.85C, then followed by the second one in the same line, and in their length at 0.500C. What is the length of each ship as measured from the other? The first thing that will come to mind, we are talking about length contraction, which is going to be L equals L0 times the square root of 1 minus B squared over C squared. Now, what is that V squared? Well, that V squared better be the, remember we did that length contraction where we just had two things relative to each other. So we better get the difference, the speed that one sees relative to the other, and that will have nothing to do with the Earth, obviously, so we need that relative to each other. So what are we going to do? I think we'll name our B, the Earth again, that's standing still, and we have C, I think we'll call, okay, so we'll call this Earth. C I'll call number 2, and A I'll call number 1, purely because, remember, I can also do this triangle something like this. This will still be B, that will still be C, that will still be A. In other words, B standing still, C will be the second slower one, and then from the second slower one, there's one even faster. So what are we given? The first one is launched at the first one, so we'll have again, we'll have C being 2, A being 1, and B being the Earth. Let's see. So we were given, first one launched at 0.850C relative to the Earth. The first one relative to the Earth, that's going to be VAB. That's going to be VAB. That was at 0.850C. Now the second one relative to the Earth, the second one C relative to the Earth, second one relative to the Earth is VCB. CB equals 0.500C. And we want now relative to each other. So that will be AC. So no matter which drawing I make, I mean, if I want to say they're moving away in that direction, this order of your triangle must stay the same. Okay, so we're looking for V. Between the two spacecraft, we're looking for VAC. And C equals, I know, now if we know in the equation for VAC, we've done the algebra on that. So when I plug that in for VAC, let's just write it again, I'm just going to have a look there, it's VCB minus VAB divided by VAB, VCB, the order of those don't matter, divided by C squared minus 1. I'm going to get that for VAC, and that VAC will be my V there, the relative velocity relative to each other. Relative to each other. And if I plug this into there, and I square it, and I divide it by C squared, and I subtract it from 1, and I take the square root of that, and I multiply it by. Now, which is the proper length? Remember, the proper length, which one of these is proper length? Proper length is going to be the 1.5, it's going to be the 1.5 kilometers. So if you multiply all of that by the 1.5 kilometers, I get an answer of, my answer was 1.19 kilometers. So, inasmuch as you're multiplying 1.5 kilometers by the square root number that you get there. So from one spaceship, it's going to measure the other spaceship as being 1.19 kilometers long. Okay, last problem for us. Two identical particles move towards each other in a particle collider. They each have the same mass, and they each are each of them at the same speed, 2.1 times 10 to the power 8 meters per second, so about 2/3 c. It's a bit around about 2/3 c. Speed of one particle relative to the other, we want to know, and what would be the relativistic momentum of one according to the other. So for relativistic momentum, we remember that P equals mv divided by the square root of 1 minus v squared over c squared. Again, as in the previous problem, this v is the one as seen by the other, which is the first part of the question that we do need. So, which is which? They each have a speed of that as measured by some scientist, it should say, in the laboratory. So again, we're going to make that B is going to be the lab, and you can make any particle can now be any particle in as much as we know one's velocity relative to the Earth, we know the other one's velocity relative to the Earth. So what we want again is the VAC, because we want to know their relative speeds, speeds relative to each other, so we want VAC again. And if you plug in VAC, we've got that VCB minus, I've always got to look, VAB divided by VCB, VAB divided by C squared minus 1. I can plug that in, that'll be my VAC, which appears there, but it also appears there because according to one, he'll be standing still and the other one will be rushing towards him. Or vice versa, the other one sees himself as standing still and this one rushing towards him, but this certainly is their relative velocity towards each other. And if I plug this value of V in there, and in there I get a relativistic momentum, as one would see, of the other, of about 6.0, just check on your calculator, 6.09 times 10 to the power negative 17 kilograms, meters per second for momentum. Okay.